guys, what's up? It's Cort. Welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, welcome. If you're returning, welcome back. Today we are going to be doing a book tour of my newly set up bookshelf that my mom repurposed. This used to be our plant stand out on our balcony, and I thrifted a new one. And so my mom had the brilliant idea to repurpose our old plant stand to a bookshelf.
Because before this, I just had my books stacked up. And it was not that aesthetic.
Now I know where all my books are. A little reading nook to the left of me that has like my TBR shelf. I know the TBR carts are super popular, like the white ones with like the three tiers, but I have a little shelf. You'll see what I mean in a second. I also have a cart on the right of me that is my to be donated, to be sold cart. I'll show you guys the bookshelf overall. That is what the whole video is about, but I'll also mention the TBR shelf and the to be donated shelf. So with all that being said, let's jump right on into the video.
Okay, so I think that I want to start off by showing you the little book corner, book nook reading section that I made, just because it is the least to tackle out of my bookshelf book collection. So yeah, this is just my little book nook where I like to read if I'm not on the couch or in bed or in the bath or something. I like to read over here. I have this beautiful string of hearts that I just bought. The tag is still on it, but it is beautiful and it's extremely long, so that's hanging there. I have a vintage little straw bag, and there's actually like the card from when the person bought it years ago, and then this bag that my friend Maddie sent me from Japan. All of the furniture in here is thrifted or secondhand, so I can't really link anything for you guys, but I would recommend checking out your local Facebook marketplace or your local thrift stores, things like that. Literally everything is thrifted besides the books, but like right here, I like to keep the book that I'm currently reading and the highlighter of choice, which are these erasable Pilot Fixion ones. And then I'm reading Love in Other Words currently. So I like to keep this on the little footstand, and then the chair. I have a Viking glass. I collect Viking glass. And then here is the well-known, famous, to be famous TBR shelf. So it looks like this. So nice, so fancy. These are also the books that I most recently bought, so we'll do a little baby book haul in this video. I have nothing but blackened teeth. Very short read, hoping to read this next. I have The Fine Print by Lauren Asher. I want to start this series. Everybody keeps talking about it, so I did add that to my book haul. Manhunt by Gretchen Fletcher Martin. Oh, I am so excited for this book. So definitely pumped for that one. Of course, you guys know I am a Grady Hendrix fan. This is the Southern Book Club's Guide to Slaying Vampires. This one's also based in Charleston. This one is the Paperbacks from Hell, and it is a signed copy. So yeah, you can see it says, "Welcome to Hell, Grady." Then moving down, we also have the other purchase that I made, and this is from Amazon. These are the Twisted Tales books, and I've heard a ton of things. They're basically like the evil or alternative version of Disney stories, so I justified it because I wanted this one as an early birthday present. It's the unbirthday. What if Wonderland was in Perel and Alice was very, very late? So I did justify buying this one. I bought it off of Amazon as an early birthday present, and then I also saw this, which was the whole first set of the Twisted Tales. So it came with Once Upon a Dream, What If Belle's Mother Cursed the Beast, A Whole New World, which is like the Aladdin one, and Oldest Time, which I think is the Sleeping Beauty one, yeah. So I have those there, basically my to be read section, and then I just have some notebooks and planners down there and some little like random things. Anyways, moving over to the side is where my main bookshelf is, and then of course I have the little donate section, which is nothing crazy. I just have one book that I'm donating, which is Frederick Bachman's Anxious People, and then The Ghost of Charleston, which is going to my mom when she comes to visit next. And then I have some Charleston little like pamphlets and like information and stuff that I always give when like friends or family visit, to see if they want to do anything. So that's my little like giveaway cart. But anyways, on to the main event of my main bookshelf. I do want to acknowledge I have this really cool bookish, like vintage print up here that I think is really neat. And then right here in this white space, I want to put some either book pages or like glue books coming up the shelf. I'm gonna do something like that, and I also need to get a lampshade. But that's it for like the decor adjustments. Outside of that, everything is pretty much how I want it to be. So let's just jump into the book tour. So starting at the very top shelf, we have my Stephen King collection, and I love to grab for these during like October and like spooky time. So I have Stephen King's memoir On the Craft of Writing. I haven't read that yet, but I'm very excited to dive into that. I actually thrifted that one. And then I have Stephen King's It, Bazaar of Bad Dreams, If It Bleeds, Gerard's Game, The Outsider, and then Sleeping Beauties. So I'm very excited for those. And then when we go on to the second shelf, I have all of my poetry books. So I've got Film for Her, Pillow Thoughts 1-4. I love Courtney Peppermill. She's one of my favorites. We have Watering the Soul and The Way Back Home. These two actually go together. They are such a cute cover. I just love them. And then I have The Road Between by Courtney Peppermill as well. This is a poetry book that we got when we were in California hiking, Yosemite, Redwoods, that kind of deal. And then I also have my Greenhouse. Not a specific poet that I like normally, but I just gravitated towards it because it was a plant-related poetry book. I also have The Rose That Blooms in the Night, Chameleon Aurora. I also randomly have this Bad Feminist Essays here as well. And then we get into my Ruppy Car collection. I have Milk and Honey, of course, The Sun and Her Flowers, Homebody. I love Ruppy Car. I saw her reading live at a poetry event, which was really, really cool. Highly recommend if she ever comes near you. And then I have Demi Lovato's Staying Strong, 365 Days a Year. I've had this since like middle school, and just a really cool book. It has a quote for every single day of the year in here, and then kind of like a lesson or like what she wants you to get from it. I have a You Are Here poetry book. My mom gave this to me and wrote in it. I did kind of get it wet, but it says happy 21st birthday. So yes, that was from my mom. I have We Hope This Reaches You in Time, Empty Bottles Full of Stories. Then we move over to the second side of the first shelf, which is again more poetry. I have Planting Gardens in Graves, volume 3, 2, and 1. I loved this like poetry series, I guess. She just wants to forget what poets are like, the up and down of writing with Gary Soto. I have not read that yet, but it looks very interesting. Winter Roses After Fall, Falling Towards the Moon, Dog Songs, Born to Love, Cursed to Feel. This is a really good poetry book. Dirty Pretty Things is very different from a poetry book that I would normally pick up, but I like it. Submerged, Flux Inward, Swimming Lessons, Love Her Wild. Then we have Write the Poem, which is just like a way to like write your own poetry and like kind of guided. Note to Self by Connor Franta. This is also a really, really cool poetry book, and it has pictures and photography that he's taken. And then The Storyteller's Workshop by Adrienne Young. Again, another way of like writing with a little bit of guidance. Come down to the second shelf. This is actually my fiance Redis's bookshelf, or like half of a shelf. He knows what he likes, so he just gets one. And they are all of the Dan Brown books, which I am so happy to say I thrifted all of these for him. We've got Deception Point, Digital Fortress, Lost Symbol, Origin, Angels and Demons, Da Vinci Code, Inferno, 2 international copies of books from Dan Brown, and then he also has The Alchemist and You Are Here Camping, which just has like different camping spots to check out. So that's his little book section. And then over on this side, I kind of switched into like seasonal sections. You'll see this is all poetry, and then we get into like real books, I guess. So right here is like my romancy Valentine's Day February section. So we have The Do-Over by Lynn Painter, If He Had Been With Me, Taylor Jenkins Reid's One True Love's, Love on the Time of Serial Killers, Last Chance Books, and then Chocolate Kisses, which is the book that I thrifted. And then ironically, next to my love section is my self-help section. So we have You're Not Special by Megan Rinks, Why Has Nobody Told Me This Before by Dr. Julie Smith, Blink, Lighter, Life is Messy, 13 Things Mentally Strong Women Don't Do by Amy Morin. This is kind of my favorite book. My favorite book ever is 13 Mentally Things Strong People Don't Do by Amy Morin. And then she came out with a feminist female version, but I love, cannot recommend enough, Calm the F Down, and then The Book of Answers, which this is kind of a cool book. I also thrifted this, and you just open it up, and it tells you an answer. So, I don't know, kind of cool, kind of different. Moving on to the third shelf, I have my kind of horror, spooky, mystery thriller section outside of Stephen King, of course. So we have How to Sell a Haunted House by Grady Hendrix, Horror Store by Grady Hendrix, Anatomy by Dana Schwartz. I loved this book. I actually had the ARC audiobook of the second one, and I pre-ordered it. It's supposed to come in soon. It's called Immorality. I'm really excited for that. Agatha Christie's Spiderweb, All the Missing Girls by Maggie Miranda, What Moves the Dead by T. King Fisher. Also love, love, love this book. One of my favorites. I want to read more books by T. King Fisher so badly. Every Vow You Break, and then some classics. We have Phantom of the Opera, Dracula, and Frankenstein. And then over on this side, we have In a Dark, Dark Woods, Many Bloody Returns, The Woman in Cabin 10, Midnight in the Garden of Good and Evil, and then Ninth House. I haven't bought the second one just because I haven't read this one yet. And then again, ironically paired next to my horror section is my summer section. So I have all of my summery, vacation-y, you know, a good time kind of vibe books. So we've got Hotel Nantucket, we've got Malibu Rising, Something in the Water, 26 Kisses, my all-time favorite book, One Italian Summer. I love this book so, so much. The Unhoneymooners by Christina Lauren. Also really like this book. People We Meet on Vacation, The Perfect Couple, The Lost Girls, and then Second Chance Summer. And then, of course, moving down to the last and final row on my bookshelf is this section and this section. And this, I guess you could call, is my fantasy section. But more or less, it's really just all of my Adrienne Young books that I won in a giveaway. And I loved Sky in the Deep. So I'm very excited to read the rest of these. And then I have the two copies of the Harry Potter illustrated versions that I want to read. I've never actually read Harry Potter, so I think this will make it a little bit easier to digest, and I'm really pumped to get into those. And then over on this side is kind of my random section, kind of books that just did not really fall into a category. So I have Kisser Once for Me, which I guess will be the start of like my December winter section. Once There Were Wolves, Untamed, Girl Online, The Overstory, Girl in Pieces, I'll Be There But I'll Be Wearing Sweatpants. We also have No One Is Talking About This, Vampires in the Lemon Grove, Siri Who Am I, In 5 Years, The Little French Bridal Shop, When Life Gives You Lemons, and The Stories We Tell by Joanna Gaines.
Alright guys, that is everything on my bookshelf, my complete book tour. I feel like once I read through a lot of those, they're gonna get like ditched. They're not gonna be on the shelf anymore, and I'm gonna make space for more books that I like, because I genuinely do not want to be overkill and have like a whole wall of books. But then again, I kind of do. But I live in an apartment, so I can't do that yet. Maybe when I have a house. Anyways, I want to make sure that I keep this small bookshelf curated. Ultimate favorites, be selective, be picky, be choosy. With the amount of books that I thrift and buy, I gotta be picky on what I keep. So, that being said, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Let me know if you guys have a book tour, bookshelf tour. I would love to watch it. If so, leave your book channel down below, and I will talk to you guys in my next video. Bye guys!